Captain, I hope Dr. Wells has... We have arrived at the Hope. I need you to... You'll have to connect me. Remember, you are not insured.
Can we talk?
Thanks.
That's the Hope's computer up ahead. I'll admit, I am curious to wake him. Greetings, Captain. I am speaking to you through the Hope's computer system. It's a rather cramped feeling, but it'll do. Are you sure? That is extremely dangerous. And also... jump-starting the skip drive.
In case I don't get another chance to say it, it's been interesting, Captain.
Doing it. I mean, affirmative. Skipping the Hope in 3, 2, 1.
ADA, does your captain seriously intend to do a micro jump in system with engines that haven't been powered in 70 years on a derelict ship?
That is what my captain intends, yes.
But that is a gross misuse of the skip drive. The Zero Point Drives Corp and I will not be held responsible for any damage incurred during transport, and this will cause extreme damage.
Yes, I am aware of that.
You should not be doing this. The humans will die.
Thank you, Hope. It looks like all systems are go. Oh, good. We are still alive and have successfully skipped into Terra 2's orbit. I reported as much to Phineas Wells, but he has not responded. Perhaps you should check in on him.
Oh. I feel like I've been turned inside out. Let's not do that again.
Captain, I am receiving. Captain, I shall now play the transmission I received.
The board is here. They've found me somehow. They're about to blast my door open. I can't stop them from getting me, and there isn't enough time to explain everything. But there's something very important you'll need to remember. The board, all their lackeys, they're all a bunch of swine. Do you hear me? They're fucking corporate swine. You fucking pigs! I'll take you all out with me! I'll never...
It would seem the recording captured some rather dire events. I presume you'll want to dock at the orbital lab to check on your associate as soon as possible. How can I be of assistance? I'll be here. We have successfully arrived at Phineas's orbital lab, Captain, and we are still in one piece. Shall I congratulate myself, or would you?
real slick.
Thank you.
Welcome aboard, Captain. Captain, as if I believe the crew would like...
So, Phineas got himself taken to Tartarus. That's usually a one-way trip.
Mr. Phineas is just about the only person with power trying to do any kind of good in Halcyon. We gotta bust him out.
To extract the scientist, you will need to infiltrate the labyrinth. But that course of action is likely to be quite dangerous, Captain. I am programmed.
Let's just...
If you really...
If we don't make...
Got my...
Count. You can...
Command.
Waiting on your... I am pleased to inform you that we have arrived at the lab. Please be advised. Oh, speak of the devil. Captain.
Attention, unauthorized spacecraft. This is a Max. You are hereby confined to your docking platform. Your ship is not permitted to leave. Only...
Captain, I would not recommend...
We're on lockdown. We have standing orders to shoot intruders. Tartarus Docking Authority. Wait, is that from the Groundbreaker? What the? Pay no mind to that. Just have a pleasant day.
Transmission terminated. How can I... See you soon, Captain.
Captain did right by us once.
What?
Now it's our turn. The board will never own Groundbreaker. Not while I breathe.
What's that noise?
Push on, Mardak.
Bodies for the rest of the world.
ever planned on seeing the inside of this place.
This might be the loneliest place in the whole system.
Nice of them to leave us a few options.
Here they come!
MSI. I'm not one for rousing speeches, but the captain needs our help. So get in there and fight!
Down they go! Well, look who it is. I'll be dead. I had heard you'd taken a mechanic.
The captain's treated me right.
Ah, and the way...
These days, I'm more interested...
When you go... I'm not in your way, you dullard. You talk to me. You want to go die in a blaze of glory? Be... Besides, I don't know what you... Yes, he is an extraordinarily obstinate fellow, isn't he? Fine, he isn't working for us per se. Semantics, he'll come around. But...
of them.
Captain, I'm afraid to your for Doctor, all that's left. In that we are in agreement. I take no pleasure in this, you know. Leaving you alive is too great. This.
You don't know how glad I am to see you. You did the right thing. Akande was a monster. Her death was much deserved and long overdue. And you, you lunatic, you broke into the board's own fortress just to rescue one doddering old man. You are absolutely out of your mind, and I can't begin to thank you enough. I'm all right, thanks to you. You've broken the board's stranglehold on this colony, and you saved my life. But there's... you and I are going to have to work harder than ever to save Halcyon. Earth has gone dark. 2 years ago, the Earth's Directorate's frigate disappeared on their way back to Earth. We don't know what they discovered when they arrived, or if they arrived at all.
They haven't exactly been hands-on around here anyway. So there's one less rubber stamp to worry about.
Earth is humanity's home planet, Miss Fenhill. The psychological effects of losing our original home will be devastating.
You mean we're all alone out here? Really alone?
I'm afraid so, Miss Holcomb. Halcyon is the only home we have left. Returning to Earth is no longer an option. We're in serious trouble, my friend. Do you know what this means for Halcyon? We can't rely on Earth for support anymore. We've been cut loose. We're entirely on our own. Yes, we do. You've done a marvelous thing. You've succeeded where anyone else would have failed, including me. We must begin the revival process immediately, starting with the Hope's brightest minds, and then we're going to fix this damn colony, one problem at a time. We're going to need a leader, and I can't imagine a better person for the job than you. What do you say, old friend? Will you help us? You've certainly earned your freedom. Halcyon is a better place with you around. You've kept your end of our bargain. Now it's time I kept mine. I'll revive the Hope's colonists myself, and we'll get on with the business of saving this colony. You're the best thing to ever happen to Halcyon. If you want to take it upon yourself to lead this colony, you have my support. We're not a colony any longer, are we? Our last connection to Earth has been severed, and so we have been set free. Our future is uncertain, and no one knows what tomorrow holds. Exciting, isn't it?
The OSI teaches that everything in the universe happens according to the grand plan. But the stranger that arrived in Halcyon was an unplanned variable. From the moment he landed in Emerald Vale, his actions altered the course of history. The events on Tartarus brought about... From the moment he landed in Emerald Vale... The OSI teaches that every... From the moment the event... The people of Halcyon were nothing if... In the years to come, Halcyon was forced to reckon with its newfound freedom. Sanjar's civil liberties and worker-centric policies were slow to catch on. In the years to come, Halcyon was forced to reckon with its newfound freedom. The collapse of Edgewater left its workers bereft of any purpose in life. Most of them made their way to Adelaide McDevitt's camp, hoping to ingratiate themselves into her favor. Adelaide accepted only a few to her community. The rest were turned away and likely died of starvation. Nevertheless, Adelaide McDevitt, under the leadership of the rediscovered Elise Lifenhouse, though part while the Neoka, the Samuel, Minister Clark, as for Dr. He eventually came to terms with his own past and was able to forgive the mistakes of his younger self by devoting his remaining years to serving the colony. Dr. Wells was able to revive many more scientists and engineers than he first expected, thanks to the additional batch of chemicals you stole from the Ministry. Wells never forgot about the human lives that were lost in acquiring these chemicals. In the end, Dr. Wells was able to save every scientist and engineer aboard the Hope. Over the next decade, nearly all of the Hope's remaining colonists were successfully revived. Halcyon saw a period of rapid technological and scientific advancement. Breakthroughs in dietary supplements saved the colony from starvation. Geoengineering projects and social reforms began to change the structure and character of the colony. Dr. Wells laid the groundwork for the project to save the colony, but he would never live to see the fruits of his labor. Today, Halcyon has stabilized. The people of the colony work hard to adapt to their new circumstances. And what about you, the unplanned variable in the history of Halcyon? You brought an end to the chaos on Tartarus and left Dr. Wells to his own devices. The affairs of the colony never distracted you from living out your own dreams, to captain a ship, to sail the ether, and to earn a reputation as the greatest spacer Halcyon ever had. No one knows what's happened to Earth, and no one knows what the future has in store for Halcyon. All we know for certain is this: the name of the Unreliable and that of its intrepid captain will remain the subject of countless stories for years to come.